Hello everybody, welcome to this next video on linear algebra. In the last video, what we have done, we have defined a linear transformation from a vector space U to say a vector space V. Right, now this is same as a function which we used to define, like which we define generally in real analysis. So you have a function from a domain set to a range set, and the moment you define a function, the next thing you do is you check whether the function is 1,1 or onto and things like that. This is what your next step is when you define a function, normal function. Now since this t is an analogous of the function, so obviously here also the next step will be to test the properties for whether it is 1,1 or onto, right? But before that, there is a concept called range and kernel or null space of t that is actually connected to this 1,1 and onto property. These things are connected. So before moving on to 1,1 and onto thing, we'll define something called range and kernel or null space for a linear transformation. So in this video, we are going to define range and kernel or null space of a linear transformation T, and then in the next video, we will go to the 1,1 and onto properties of the linear transformation. So let us see what do we mean by range and kernel of a linear transformation. So let T from U to V is a linear transformation. So you have a picture like this, that you have U here and then you have V here, then you have a map T here. So range is obviously, as generally we know, all the points here in V which are actually having free images. It means that take all the images under your map T and collect them. So range T, which is denoted as RT, is defined as T of U for all U belongs to U. So you collect it. You collect all TU. This is a vector in V. This is a vector in V. So you collect all TU. That set is called range T and it is denoted by RT. Fine. And then we define something called kernel of T or null space of T, which is denoted by NT. So this is defined as, this is your U and this is your V and here is your map T. Now what you will do, you will take all those elements in U, right, which are mapped to zero element of V. Here is the zero vector, right? So what you will do, you will collect all those elements in U which are mapped to zero element in V. This is called null space. Null space means this is going to null thing, means zero vector. So NT is defined as all those vectors in U for which TU is zero vector. Right? Now, this is how you define null T. Now, you can note that RT, which is defined as TU, U belongs to U, and NT, null space, is defined as all those U for which TU is 0. Now can you tell me this is a subset of U or V? Here you are collecting the elements of V because TU is an element of V. So it is a subset of V and it is a subset of, because here you are collecting the elements of U, so it is a subset of U. So here is something you can see, this is U. This is your V, this is your linear transformation T, here is somewhere your NT, which is a subset of U, and here is your RT, which is a subset of V. Right, okay. So first thing we would like to prove is, this NT and RT, they are vector subspaces. You see, they are the subset of subspaces. So first thing is, first important thing is, I was thinking that I'll go to the example first, but I think I can do with this property, then we'll go to examples. This is first important thing is, this NT is a subspace of U. Right? So you see, when something is a subspace, Then there are so many things. You can talk about the dimension, you can talk about the basis and so on. So subset, being a subset is nothing, but being a subspace is a big thing, right? And RT is a subspace of V. Right, so let us prove it. Let us prove that NT is a subset of U. Right, so for that, what you will do? You just write first the definition of NT. This is all those U such that TU is 0. Now we know that how we prove something is a subspace. You take two elements from that set. Let U1, U2 belongs to NT and alpha, beta are from your field. Then you want to see whether we want to check whether alpha into U1 plus beta into U2 belongs to NT or not. That will decide whether it is a subspace or not. So for that, now we know that this will belong to NT if the transformation is 0. So T of alpha U1 plus beta U2, this is what we are looking for. So this is equal to alpha T of U1 plus beta T of U2. This is only possible because T is linear. Otherwise it is not possible. So everything is true only for linear transformations. Now since T of U1 is 0, why? Because U1 belongs to NT. It implies T of U1 is 0. Similarly U2 belongs to NT. It implies T of U2 is also 0. This is alpha into 0 plus beta into 0, so you get 0. Therefore, alpha U1 plus beta U2 belongs to NT. So we get, hence, alpha U1 plus beta U2 belongs to NT for all U1, U2 belonging to NT and alpha beta in your field. Therefore, NT is a subspace. Right. Similarly, let us prove that RT is a subspace. Next, let us prove that RT is a subspace. For that, first you write what is RT. RT is T of U where U belongs to U. So you will take two elements from RT. Two elements will look like T, say you call it say V1. And V2, V1 looks like T of U1, V2 looks like TU2, right? Now alpha beta you take from field, you want to see whether alpha V1 plus beta V2 belongs to RT or not. That will decide whether it is a subspace or not. So now alpha V1 is T of U1 plus beta V2 is T of U2. So this is T alpha U1 plus beta U2. Why? Because T is linear. So it means that this alpha V1 plus beta V2 is equal to T of something, and that something is in U. Therefore, alpha V1 plus beta V2 belongs to TU. Belongs to RT. Because this is of the form TU. Right? Therefore, RT is a subspace. Right? So, this is what we got, that you have a vector space U, you have a vector space V, you have a linear transformation. This is important that it should be linear. You can't talk about any transformation. Then you have something called here which is called null space. Right? And you have something here which is called range space, RT. So, you have null space, RT here, this is a vector subspace, and this is also a vector subspace. Now, because when something is a vector subspace, we can talk about the dimension. So, dimension of NT, it is called nullity of T. Nullity of T, right, denoted generally by N. And dimension of RT is called rank of T, denoted by R. So, in the next videos, we'll look at the examples of null space and range space, and we'll talk about nullity and rank, and we'll see how we can connect these two subspaces with the property of 1, 1 and on 2. And I would like to tell you people that we are having Maths for All as our website. The link is in the about of Maths for All channel. If you go about in the about of Maths for All YouTube channel, you'll get a link for Maths for All website. And I can put that in the video itself. I can put that link in the video description itself. And then in that website, on that website, you'll get a section of quiz. Right? There we are preparing quizzes for you people. So if you want to check that if you're learning this course or not, then you can go to that site and you can check yourself for these questions, which are based on whatever I'm teaching, so that you can have an idea of how you are progressing in this course. Thank you.